We're still here.
Amen. Thank God.
Despite the mask, but God knows when. Yeah. He knows how, he knows when.
Amen.
We have to give an account.
Yeah.
And just thank God for just being here.
Amen. Amen.
So many people didn't make it.
Amen.
We got a lot to be grateful for.
Yes, sir.
We have to praise him and give him thanks.
Amen.
And pray for those who are less fortunate.
Praise God.
Yes.
God does things in his time.
Amen.
And he's a wonderful God. And mighty powerful God.
Thank you.
We have a lot to be grateful for.
Amen.
Yes.
Thank you for health and strength this morning.
Amen.
And just pray that he keep us in his care.
Thank you.
And keep the ones that's not able to be here.
Amen.
In his care. Just give them strength and encourage them. Know he has all power.
Yes, he does.
And when he get ready to turn the coronavirus off, he'll turn it up.
Amen. Amen.
But in the meantime, we have to do what the CDC tells us.
Amen. Amen.
We have to trust in the Lord.
Trust in the Lord. Amen.
He'll do it. Our son going to be just as close to walk with thee.
Amen.
Ernie's going to give a scripture, then we're going to do a prayer, then we're going to turn it back in the hands of our pastor.
Amen.
Amen.
Just a closer walk with thee. Grant it, Jesus, if you please.
Guide me safely to a shore.
I'm going to read Hebrews 11, 1 through 10.
All right.
Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for.
All right.
The evidence of things not seen. For by it the elders obtained a good report. Through faith, we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that things which are seen were not made of things which do appear. By faith, Abel offered unto God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain, by which he obtained witness that he was righteous, God testifying of his gifts, and by it he being dead yet speak. By faith, Enoch was translated that he should not see death, and was not found because God had translated him. For before his translation, he had his testimony that he pleased God. But by faith, it is impossible, but without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him.
Amen.
By faith, Noah, being warned of God of things not seen as yet, moved with fear, prepared an ark to the saving of his house, by which he condemned the world, and became heir of the righteousness which is by faith. By faith, Abraham, when he was called to go out into a place which he should after receive for an inheritance, obeyed, and he went out, not knowing whither he went. By faith, he sojourned in the land of promise, as in a strange country, dwelling in tabernacles with Isaac and Jacob, the heirs with him of the same promise. For he looked for a city which had foundations, whose builder and maker is God.
Amen.
May God add blessing to the readers, hearers, and doers of his holy word.
Amen.
Let us pray. This morning, Heavenly Father, we come, Lord, with our head bowed down one more time.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
We come to say thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Lord, upon us, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
We come to say, Lord, thank you for just keeping us in your care.
Yes,
Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
We come to tell you thank you, Lord, because when we woke up this morning,
yes, Lord,
we realized that it could have been the other way.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, but because of your grace, your mercy,
your grace, another opportunity, Lord,
to put our feet on your holy ground.
Yes, yes.
We thank you, Lord, for bringing us back to the house of worship.
Yes,
one more time, Lord.
One more time.
In spite of all the things that we're going through, all the things that's going on in the world, Lord. But we know that you are a mighty, powerful, and mighty good God, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Lord, you allow things to happen to
us,
so we can get ourselves together, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
And we ask you, Lord, just to bless us and keep
bless
us,
Lord.
Bless
us, Lord.
To be stayed on thee, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
You got all the answers, and we know you can do anything but fail, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
But during this time that we're in time out, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
During this pandemic situation, Lord.
Yes,
Lord. All the things that's going on in the world, Lord, we ask you, Lord, just to bless us, Lord.
Bless
us. Yes,
Lord. Lord, you got all power. You can fix anything when you get rid of, Lord. But
thank you, Jesus.
Right now, Lord, we have to deal with what you're putting upon this world, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
We ask you, Lord, just to bless in a mighty way,
bless
Lord.
Bless in a mighty way,
keep
Lord.
The believers, Lord, and the non-believers, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Stay on thee right now,
yes,
Lord.
Yes, Lord.
We ask you, Lord, just to bless this church
bless
right now,
this
Lord. And the members that's here, here right now,
yes,
Lord.
Yes,
Lord. The members that's not here, Lord.
Yes, bless
the members
Lord.
That want to come out, Lord, but,
yes,
they're, but
yes.
they're just not able to make it right
yes,
now, Lord.
Lord.
We ask you, Lord, just to strengthen their faith,
strengthen.
Lord. Give them an understanding that you don't do nothing wrong,
yeah,
Lord.
Yeah.
And things happen for a reason and one reason only, Lord. And you got all power, Lord. You can fix
yes,
the situation
Lord.
When you get ready, Lord.
Yeah, fix
we
it,
ask
Lord.
You, Lord, to bless our pastor this morning.
Yeah.
Bless
yeah.
him to preach a word
yes,
Lord,
Lord.
To your people, Lord, that in here and not here, Lord.
Yes,
Lord. Online, Lord. We ask you, Lord, just to give us all an understanding about in His word, Lord.
Yeah.
While we're going through this situation.
Yes, Lord.
And we go through this to give us the faith to endure, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Right now, Lord, everybody don't have the same feeling and
have
the same
faith, Lord. Yes,
Lord. Somebody dealing with anxiety, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Somebody
has
an anxiety attack,
Help
Lord.
Us, Lord.
Somebody don't know where the next meal is going to come from, Lord. Somebody need a bill paid and they don't have a job.
Help us, Lord.
They're not drawing unemployment, Lord.
Yes.
Don't know where the bill's going to come from, Lord.
Yes.
Don't know how they're going to pay the light bill, Lord.
Yes.
But I find out in my everyday life,
Lord,
that you're a way maker, Lord.
Thank you.
Can make a way out of no
way,
Lord. You can make the impossible possible,
Lord.
You can make things when they seem dim, Lord, that you can shine a bright light in their life,
Lord.
And we ask you, Lord, just to give us the faith and give us an understanding, Lord, and to have mercy upon our minds,
Lord,
our heart, and our soul this morning, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
We ask you, Lord, and we pray this morning to bless every church that's opening your name.
Bless us, oh Lord.
And we ask you, Lord, just to bless every pastor that's preaching the word to your people, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
At times like this, right now,
yes,
Lord, we need a Savior like you, Lord.
Yes.
At times like this, Lord, we need you, Lord, just to walk with us, Lord, and to talk with us, Lord, and to show us what we need to do, Lord, and send your Holy Spirit and guide us in the right direction.
Yes, Lord.
And Lord, we pray, Lord, that, that we be able to bless each other and share love with each other, Lord. And bless to say something, Lord, that's going to lift somebody up and not tear them down, Lord.
Bless.
We ask you, Lord, bless somebody likewise, Lord,
that
when we're down in our spirit, that you can bless somebody to send us our way to be able to share the light on us.
Yes, Lord.
Sometimes, Lord, we get down in our spirit, Lord.
Yes,
sometimes, Lord, we don't know which way to
lift
go.
Up,
we don't know which way to turn, Lord. And we ask you, Lord, just to send somebody our way, Lord.
Yeah.
Or let the word shine in our heart that, that you taught us that everything is going to be all
right,
Lord.
Keep us in your care.
Keep us, Lord. Yeah. We need you, Lord. And we cannot live without you, Lord. Lord, at times like this, Lord, we need a Savior, Lord.
We need you, Lord.
To walk on this faith to this earth, Lord.
Because
there's trouble on every side, Lord.
Yes.
There's trouble in every house, Lord.
Yes.
Lord, there's nobody right now except for nothing right now, Lord.
Yes.
We all going through the same thing right now, Lord.
Yes.
There's no big eyes and no little U's right now, Lord.
Yes.
We're all dealing with the same situation, at the same time, Lord.
Yes.
And we serve a mighty good God that can do anything Lord. Lord, with all the bereavement, Lord, we ask you, Lord, just to bless the people that's on the sick bed, Lord, and going through this coronavirus, Lord, and going through heartaches and pain, Lord, and people loved ones dying, Lord, and there's nobody right now except right now, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
We need you, Lord, in a mighty way, Lord.
Yes.
We need you, Lord, in a mighty way, Lord.
Yes.
Lord, we thank you, Lord.
Thank you, God,
Lord.
Thank you.
And we're calling on you, Lord, because we realize you're a way maker, Lord. Somebody worried about the job going to close down, Lord. Somebody worried about they don't have the money to pay the light bill with, Lord. Don't know how they're going to pay the light bill, Lord. But I find out, Lord, that you can do anything
but fail,
Lord. Lord, we thank you, Lord, in advance, Lord. So many people sick with the virus.
Yes,
Lord. So many people sick with cancer, Lord. Somebody, so many people sick with heartache, Lord.
Yes.
Somebody ache with pain this morning, Lord.
Touch,
and they're scared to go to the hospital, Lord.
Touch,
because they don't want to get caught in the midst of that situation, Lord. But I realize, Lord, that you're a doctor, Lord, that never lost a patient. And we got to have faith that you can turn this thing around.
Touch,
Lord, we ask you, Lord, just to bless our lawmakers and our president at times like this, Lord.
Yes.
Lord, right now we need a Savior, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Right now there's trouble on every hand.
Yes,
Lord. There's trouble in the White House, Lord.
Need you,
there's
Lord.
Trouble in the job house, Lord.
Yes,
there's
Lord.
Even trouble in my house sometimes, Lord.
Yes,
and I ask you, Lord, just to bless in a mighty
bless
way.
Bless in a mighty way.
Know you can do anything.
Yes, bless in a mighty way.
Be mighty good to us, Lord.
Yes.
If we ever open our eyes this morning, in spite of how
thank
thin
you,
things
Jesus.
Are, if you're able to
thank
open
you,
our eyes, Lord,
yes.
if we're able to open our mouths this morning,
thank
Lord,
you.
That's what happens when we thank
you,
Lord. If we're able to put our feet on the ground, if we're able to walk this morning, Lord, in spite of all the things, just enough to tell you thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
And we're able to put food in our mouth, Lord.
Thank
you. In spite of how bad things are.
Yes,
that's enough to tell you thank you, Lord.
Yes,
we got enough to be grateful for you, Lord.
We are trusting in the Lord and according to
Praise God.
Praise the Lord this morning.
Praise God.
He's worthy this morning.
Yeah.
Understand it better by and by.
Yes.
Yes,
sir.
But we'll understand it better
by and by.
Church, say amen.
Amen. Amen.
We thank God for him allowing us to be here.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
We thank the folks that committed the deacons this morning. Amen.
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 Amen. Praise God.
Amen.
We give all praise to our Heavenly Father. Honor to all I'm just doing just good to be here today.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Realizing that truly could have been the other way.
Yes, sir.
Praise God.
And God has allowed us here.
Amen.
On this spot of ground once again.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you,
Lord.
Amen. Amen. I was sitting there listening to the devotional service, and you know, once you get in contact with the Lord,
man,
you tend to reflect more about who you are.
Oh, yeah.
And the things you've been through.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
And where maybe God want to take you.
Amen.
Oh, yeah.
And once you get in communion with God, into a relationship with God, especially when people are talking about God, singing about God, praising him.
Yeah.
And we come into the presence of him.
Oh, yeah.
Praise God.
It's almost overwhelming sometimes.
Amen. Amen.
Because we can pick out certain points in our path.
Yes, sir.
Oh, yeah.
That we like, when alive with God.
Oh, yeah.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen.
Whether it's an accomplishment.
Right.
Whether it was coming out of a bad situation.
Yeah.
Right.
Or something we've done, we can actually know that it was God that got us where we are.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
And like I said, that's one sometimes I almost become overwhelming to think how good and how gracious he was to allow us to reach that goal or to get past that habit or whatever it was. Right. It's just God that did.
Yeah. Amen.
Uh-huh. So in this particular day,
oh, yeah.
Coming up to our Thanksgiving.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
That's been on my mind. Amen.
Praise God.
And I'm glad God placed it on my mind.
Uh-huh.
Because too often that Thanksgiving is all about the meal.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
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 The potato pies and the butter rolls and the Amen. You can throw a little turkey there on the side, but it's all about eating and laughing and having a good time.
Amen. Amen.
But God has placed it in me to just say, I need to be more thankful.
Thank you.
You know, I try to get up every morning. I said it out loud. I try to get up every morning with God on my mind.
Amen.
Thanking him for everything.
Yes.
All
oh, yeah. Yeah.
But every now and then, and maybe more time than it ought to be.
All right.
I get up like this.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
God.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And so God is saying, no, we need to be more thankful. Each and every day for what he's doing.
Each and every day.
Amen. And every day.
Every day.
Is a day of thanksgiving.
Yes. Every day.
I don't got old enough to know now that I didn't get here by myself. This or that or that or this, but it wasn't nobody but God.
Amen.
And I thank God for allowing us here this morning.
Amen.
I got a scripture to read real quick and get out the way. Amen. 117 number of Psalms. It says, oh, praise the Lord, all ye nations. Praise him, all ye people. For he is merciful. Kindness is great towards us.
Mm-hmm.
The truth of the Lord endureth forever. Praise ye the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
That first verse in 118 said, oh, give thanks unto the Lord.
Uh-huh.
For he is good. Mm-hmm. Because his mercy is endured forever.
Amen.
And so we got to understand that
It is God's grace and His mercy.
Yeah,
has allowed us to be here. And I
thank
God for that. Amen. So, Sam, you go ahead and say the way. I ain't ready to preach it. Amen. Amen.
All right.
Amen. Thank you. Amen. But that was our scripture for the morning. Well, let's praise God for who He is. And all that He has allowed us to come.
Thank you, Lord.
And concerning the day by our sick and shut in, who would have one of our sick and shut in with us today?
I have a First Lady on the Carter. I have a Patricia Jackson, so she can continue to get well. Tony Lockett, the Miller family, the Lester family, the Morgan Grove family, our new president and vice president, and Amen. The whole world.
Amen.
Me now, my kindness and your grace, Father.
Yes.
Father, we thank you for your mercy, Father.
Yes.
Father, we thank you because you are God.
Yes.
Father, we thank you for the rising of the sun and the going down
yes,
of the sun. Father, we thank you this morning, Father.
Yes.
Realizing, Father, it could have been the other way.
Yes.
Father, we thank you this morning, Father.
Thank you.
Father, you're good, you're kind, you're wonderful, you're gracious, Father, you're merciful, Father. We thank you this morning, Father. We say that we love you, Lord, and Father, ain't nothing nobody can do about it. We thank you this morning, Father. Father, we got our minds stayed on you, Father. Father, in spite of the problem, in spite of the COVID, Father, you're still our God, Father, and you can do anything but fail, Father. Father, we know if you got us here, you're going to bring us out, Father. We said thank you this morning, Father. Father, you heard all the names on the sick list and the prayer list this morning, Father.
Yes.
You heard about the bereaved family, Father.
Yes.
Father, we said thank you this
morning,
Father. Father, special prayer for Miss Arthur Reed and the blessed care, Father. We said thank you this morning, Father. Continue to bless this church, this board of members, Father.
Yes.
Bless the one that's watching from home, Father.
Yes.
Bless the one that's not able to come back right now, Father.
Yes.
Father, we said thank you this morning, Father. We pray that this COVID is out of here soon, Father.
Yes.
We pray that the vaccine will work, Father.
Yes.
Above all, Father, we pray that you'll eradicate this virus, Father.
Yes.
Get it out of here, Father.
Get it out.
Thank you, Father, we can live like we once have again.
Yes.
But Father, make it where we know that you are God. Father, we said thank you this morning.
Thank you.
Now, Father, bless this church.
Bless.
And the members. Continue to bless and keep us in all that we do. We ask all this in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
May you see that.
Amen.
Now it's time for our tithes and offerings. If we have our tithes and offerings and bring it at this time. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for these tithes and offerings.
Thank you.
We ask that we will use it in the purpose for which it was raised.
Yes.
We ask that you would bless the giver, Father.
Bless, Lord.
That it be blessed, double blessed, blessed
Lord.
A thousand times over, Father.
Yes.
We ask all this in Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 Thank you. Amen. We have mentioned the COVID. I think all of us is on our mind. We have made COVID our God, but we would be foolish not to talk about it.
Amen.
Or have it on our mind.
Praise God.
Amen. If you know that danger is out there,
Amen.
Each one won't be
here.
Amen. You're so right in knowing it's not going to help. So let's continue to do everything that they're asking us to do. I mentioned Sister Carl, we don't know from what point. She could have received it, but we're big on our mask and doing all the right things. It's just one of those things.
Amen.
And that's where for lots of people, they don't know exactly where they got it from.
Amen.
But we thank God that the survival rate in America is under 1%, over 99.7% now. That people are really surviving once they catch it.
Amen.
People with underlying conditions such as heart conditions and diabetes or some type of other type of disease, it takes them out, amen. But we thank God that it's only less than 1% dying versus it could have been the other way around.
Amen.
Thank God. Continue to do what they're asking us to do.
Amen.
This Thursday is our Thanksgiving.
Oh, yeah.
I think traditionally, Mark, we don't do a Thanksgiving program, but we want to be in prayer for one another on Thanksgiving
Amen.
Morning.
Amen.
Let's take a moment. Around 12, I'm asking everybody, whether you're cooking, you don't have to, stop what you're doing. You don't have to do anything. Just at around 12 on Thursday, just say a prayer for Morgan, Pastor Carl,
amen.
Please pray for him, amen.
Amen.
And the entire church family that we will be stronger in the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Because I've found out, and the Bible says it specifically, if you attack the head or the leader.
Come on, preacher.
Amen.
Right.
It'll break up everything else, huh?
Come on, preacher.
Uh, coming.
Amen.
Oh, yeah.
We got a little prayer. I say, amen.
Amen.
Oh, yeah.
Amen.
They sure be like, we were coming to get you for all them prayers. God got a big fence around you.
Amen.
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 And lots of times we don't pray for something
right
until it happens.
Amen.
Y'all know who's getting the truth. Amen.
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 Right. Right.
But same thing in your homes. Pray for your leadership in your home. If you the leader at your house, pray for yourself.
Amen.
That God would put a protection around
Amen.
You.
Amen.
Because things will come up and tear everything down.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen. Any other announcements? Of course, this year, right now, don't know if we're going to have the Hammond Hill Conference of Christian Education Breakfast Live, but I think we're going to end up having it via Zoom. So as I get all the information, I'll let you know, but it's normally the second Saturday in December.
Yeah.
So we'll let you know. The North Mississippi Baptist Christian Education Convention was Monday and Tuesday. Mm-hmm. It went over well, and I believe they had over 4,500 people to watch the sessions.
And, right, God.
And so that went well. Well, God is doing a new thing.
New thing.
Yeah.
And, and the new thing is technology.
Amen.
When it's all over with, Bible class, amen.
Amen.
All right.
We can do that on Zoom, huh?
Amen.
All right.
We never thought about that before, did we? Amen.
Amen.
Everybody can be at home, or two or three here at the church, and
amen.
We still can do
Bible.
We still can do Bible class, right?
Right.
So next thing, I know I'm going on a little bit. Next thing, we're getting ready to pretty soon. We ought to get our choir back. Amen.
Amen.
We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Put one that in. 7.
Amen. That's all.
8. Amen. We didn't have many more than that. We might get our five back. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. But hopefully and prayerfully, this vaccine will be here pretty soon.
Amen.
And we can get to more of a norm.
Right.
Don't seem like it's going to be here pretty soon. Zoom, we're going to have to start rehearsing on Zoom.
Amen.
Y'all come on.
Amen.
Zoom.
Okay.
B. Milk. Zoom. Amen.
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 Zoom.
Zoom. Amen.
Zoom.
Okay.
Amen. Zoom. We might get this together. Amen.
Amen.
I thank God is happy with what we're doing.
Amen.
But I think when we come to church, I like to feel. Now, Deacon prayed like he was back in the 60s early. Amen.
All right.
Amen. Amen.
Knee
bent and body bowed. You pray like one of the old deacons was.
Amen.
Amen. I mess with you, deacon, but when we come to church, we want to come to
praise God.
We don't just want to be going through the motions. Amen.
Praise
amen.
The Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
And praise go up, blessings come down. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We want to sing so that the angels pay attention. Who is the Lord and road down there singing? Praise
amen.
Unto our God.
Amen.
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 That's all the announcements I have. Any other announcements? Amen. Amen. Do we have a song this morning? Amen.
Every day is a day of thanksgiving. God's been so good to me. Every day He's blessing me. Glorify the Lord today. Take the time to glorify the Lord today.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We thank you, Deacon Hayes, for that selection. Amen.
Amen.
That was a song that we played this morning on the broadcast at 9.
Amen.
And we should really, truly take the time to glorify the Lord.
Yes.
Amen.
He's teaching every day.
Amen. Amen.
Our God, He's truly worthy.
Yes, He is.
To be praised.
Amen.
Yes,
He is.
Our ABCs of salvation before we get into the sermon. A to B to C. A, admit you are a sinner and have made mistakes. B, believe that Jesus is God's Son and died on the cross for you and rose up on the grave, from the grave on the third day.
Mm-hmm.
Confess Jesus as your Lord of your life and commit yourself to a life of following Jesus and serving others. And then we ask that you read the 10th chapter of Romans, but more specifically the 1st through the 17th verse to give you a good overview about the road to salvation.
Mm-hmm.
Our God is awesome God.
Yes, He is.
And He's worthy to be praised.
Yeah.
Our sermon this morning comes from Colossians, the 3rd chapter, the 14th through the 17th verse. Colossians, the 3rd chapter, 14 through the 17th verse. Amen. Amen. And above all these things, put on charity, which is the bond of perfectness, amen. And let the peace of God rule in your heart, to which you also, ye are called in one body, and be ye thankful. Let the word of God dwell in you richly, in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord. 17. And whatsoever you do in the word or deed, do it in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God and the Father by Him. May God bless the reading here and do it of the whole word. And I take my subject for a little while. True thanksgiving. True thanksgiving. Amen. Amen. Our God, amen. Thank you. Blessed, amen. Our God has been awesome and great to us for ever and ever and ever. Amen.
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 Paul is writing to the Colossian church, is writing to them about the different things that have rolled about their dietary, how they will eat meat or not eat meat, or when to eat it, and the Sabbath day. Paul writes to them and talks to them about lots of things. They had even got to the point of believing that they should worship angels over God, amen. He's writing to them to let them know that above all things, they should worship God, amen.
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 Above everything, they should have God first place in their life. Amen.
Amen.
And so as we get to this 3rd chapter in Colossians, it tells us that whatsoever we do in deed or word, actions, we should put God in the forefront.
All right.
And then it said we should give thanks to the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
For all that is going on. Amen.
Yeah.
We know as Christians, sometimes we have a tendency to put God second, amen, and say that it's all about us, or the things that we have learned how to do on our own. Amen. Mm-hmm. Well, in today's sermon, amen, we're going to talk about that how it has been difficult this year.
Amen.
And how some of us have been struggling.
All right.
With the idea.
All right.
Of being thankful.
Come on, preacher.
It's hard to be thankful when we look around and we see all this COVID-19 all around us.
Yes, Lord.
It has separated us to where we can't have Sunday dinners.
Uh-huh. Right.
We can't even just have backyard barbecue.
That's right.
For the ones that like to sit on the back and smoke a cigar with a group of people. We can't do any of that. And we just find it hard to see that says thankful this year. Mm-hmm.
All right.
Everybody, in one way or another, has been touched by this COVID-19.
Yeah. Right.
Amen. And it makes it hard for us to be thankful this year. Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir.
We're looking forward to Thursday, and you said, Brother Pastor, why should I be so thankful? The 25 that I normally have at my house every year,
all right,
or the house I go to that have 25 or 30, I'm not going to be able to do it this year. Amen.
All right.
Well, we still ought to be able to say that we are thankful. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
We ought to be able to say that we are thankful not just because we kept our job during the pandemic, mm-hmm, or if we lost a job, we found another one, mm-hmm, or if God kept food on our table. We want to be thankful for all them things, but if we really want to be thankful, mm-hmm, we ought to be thankful that God sent his darling son,
yes,
to die for us.
Right.
Amen.
Right.
Thank
you.
Right.
The true meaning of Thanksgiving is that we ought to be thankful for what God has already done.
Amen.
And too often we look at things that what we might be able to get out of God, or we might be able to get because we asked for, or we already received material things, but we ought to be thankful because God is God and he has sent his son to redeem us.
Yes.
True Thanksgiving. Amen.
Amen. True Thanksgiving.
They tell us in the Bible, if they preach anything other than Christ come died and crucified and raised again from above, I mean from the grave, then we're preaching an untrue God.
All right.
We got to preach the true gospel. Mm-hmm. And the true gospel is we ought to be thankful. Amen.
All right.
We didn't have a way back to Christ, I mean to God, no way but through Christ. Mm-hmm. And we ought to be thankful for that.
Amen.
Somewhere down the line, amen, somebody said, Brother Pastor, I don't have a whole lot to be thankful for. Mm-hmm. People don't walk off from me.
All right.
Some people don't die, amen.
All right,
all
right.
I don't lost my job. I don't lost all that I have.
All right.
But we still ought to be thankful.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
Why ought we ought to be thankful? We ought to be thankful because we still have a way back to God. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
If you're still messing up, if you're still living on the other side of the fence, or you're still straddling the fence,
on,
or you're going back and forth, you still ought to be thankful.
Yeah,
amen.
Yeah.
I'm not going to get into it today, but for the ones that are looking at the one going back and forth across the fence, amen.
All right.
For the ones that are looking at the one that straddling the fence all the time. For the ones that look at the ones that they ought not be doing that, we're going to preach about this another time. But let God be God. Amen.
All right.
Because we got some things we got to work on. Amen.
Yes, sir.
And I'm thankful that he allowed me to work on the things that I need to work on.
All right. All right.
But I want to let you know that because I know I can't do it by myself, I'm thankful that God is showing me and helping me along the way.
All right.
All right. I thank God this morning.
Thank you.
This morning we ought to be thankful because of we able to praise him and worship him in truth and in spirit. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
We ought to be thankful because he allowed us another chance.
Yeah.
None of us have been so perfect that we should be so high that we don't understand it was God that brought us thus far.
All right.
We're talking about true Thanksgiving.
True Thanksgiving.
Last time on Thanksgiving Day, Thanksgiving services, we get a chance to go around the room and just say, I'm thankful. I'm thankful for my wife and children, amen.
All right, all right.
Somebody's gonna say that, amen.
All right.
That's what they normally say on Thanksgiving. On Thanksgiving Day.
That's right.
Somebody's gonna say, I'm glad that I got a chance to see my children grow up.
Amen.
And be able to take care of their own self, amen. Somebody's gonna say, I'm glad because my mom, my dad is still with me.
All right.
These are the things that we normally say on Thanksgiving.
Yes, sir.
Ain't nothing wrong with those things, amen.
All right.
Ain't nothing wrong with being thankful for what God has placed before you, amen.
All right.
But you got to understand, it was God that allowed you to have that wife and children, amen.
Yeah.
It was God that allowed you to have your parents still here with you, amen.
Yeah.
It was God that allowed you to still have that spouse that you have, amen.
All right.
And so we got to put God in front of all these things.
Yeah.
A true thanksgiving,
yeah.
Amen.
Yeah. Yeah.
We got to start thanking Him like He really is the one supplying all our needs according to His
riches.
And we got to understand that it's God, amen.
Yeah.
Yes, we work all day, amen.
Yes,
I met with Him about brown, green, and red, amen.
Yes,
we work in all these different places, but guess what? God is all those places.
Yes,
we didn't get there by ourselves,
yeah.
Amen.
Yes,
we got to be thankful, amen.
All right.
True thanksgiving is to give God
true thanks.
Thankful every day.
Yes, sir.
Every day ought to be a day of thanksgiving.
Yes, sir.
Psalm 92 says it is good to give thanks unto the Lord and sing praise unto His name. Amen. We got to learn how to sing praise unto God even when we're going through. David tells us it's good to give thanks for His love and kindness. And that He is faithful and just to take care of us. He won't do no more than He said He's going to do. No less than He said He'll do. We got to be thankful.
Yeah,
amen.
Yeah.
Psalm 50 said, to offer God thanksgiving every day and pay homage to Him each and every day.
Amen.
We got to learn how to give God thanks. Amen.
Amen.
Give Him thanks even when we don't feel like giving
amen.
Thanks. Amen.
Amen.
In verse 15 of that same psalm, it said, God make a promise. He said that He would, if we should call on Him in the day of trouble, He would answer.
Right.
That's the promise that God gave unto us. And I'm thankful for that. Because I've been in trouble, amen.
Amen.
I've been down, amen.
Yeah.
I've had dirt thrown on top of my head, amen. I've been to a place where I didn't think I was going to bounce back for, but nobody but God, amen.
Yeah.
I'm thankful that He saw a little person like me, amen, and said, you're going to be my child, amen.
Yeah.
And I'm going to keep you straight, amen. God ain't keeping Himself straight. Ain't nobody but God.
Amen.
We got to learn how to be thankful, amen.
Amen.
Philippians said, be anxious for nothing, but everything. Prayer and supplication unto the Lord. We got to learn how to pray unto God and know that God got our back.
Amen.
God put us in a situation, He's going to bring us out of the situation.
Yeah.
As we go through the situation, as we go through this time out,
yes, sir.
Whatever we learn in the time out is for the glorification of God.
Amen.
I might not like to come here, but I know it's God's opportunity to make me stronger.
Yes, sir.
And so I'm thankful. So I'll be thankful on Thursday, amen.
But
ain't nobody at home but me and my wife, amen.
Right.
I won't get a chance to see my grandchildren, amen. I won't get a chance to see my daughter and son-in-law, amen.
Right.
But I'll be thankful, amen, that God is right there with us, amen.
Amen.
We're going to eat a little turkey and a little ham, amen. We're going to eat a couple pies, amen. Amen. But I'll be thankful about what God is doing for us, amen. I'll be thankful because God is good. Amen.
Yeah.
I learn how to be thankful each and every day. When I wake up in the morning, I'll be thankful.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Tomorrow, when I'm going up and down the highway, I'll be thankful that God is God that's strong.
Yeah.
And He's keeping me away from all hurt. All every time the car swerves, He's keeping it out of the way. I'm thankful because God is the true meaning of thanksgiving. I'm thankful because He has given us the power to overcome this thing called Satan. Amen. It's hard to be thankful, amen.
Come on, preacher.
For your word, amen.
All right.
It's hard to be thankful, amen.
Come on, preacher.
Amen. When you're worried about different situations in
your
life. See, the devil knows he can get your mind, amen. But the Bible says, keep your mind steady.
Yeah.
And so when you're worried, you get your mind off of Christ.
Yeah.
But I won't be thankful enough, even when I'm worried, I'm thankful about Christ. It's hard to feel like you're blessed, amen, when Yes.
Come on, Brittany.
For God said, I am able. And I keep my mind stayed on you. When we worry about focusing on the problem, and we're not worried about the answer. Jesus is the answer.
Jesus.
And we need to focus on him each and every day. We focus on our failure and not our victory.
Yeah.
The devil will have us thinking about the failure that we're going through right now and have us forget about all the victory that we have already experienced. See, we got to learn to be thankful. Amen.
Thank you.
And we start being thankful. We understand that Jesus has brought us through.
All right. Yeah.
1 Thessalonians said, rejoice.
Rejoice.
Pray without ceasing.
Yeah.
And everything,
everything.
Give thanks.
Yeah.
For this is the will of God.
Yeah.
So even though we may be going through, amen.
Yeah.
Even though it looks like the walls might be about to cave in on us.
Yeah.
Even though like we might be about to drown.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Even though it may look like we're about to lose our mind.
Yeah.
We still want to be thankful to God. True thanksgiving.
Yeah.
God will bring us out.
Yeah. Yeah.
We're talking about a situation we never thought we could make.
Yeah.
God is able, amen.
Yes.
And he's able to do anything for us. Be thankful this morning. Everything.
Yeah.
God is God.
Yes,
sir.
Yeah.
When my bills are due, God is God.
God.
When my bills are paid, God is God.
Amen.
When my friends leave me,
God
is God.
Yes, sir.
I learned that I can lean and depend on him.
Yeah.
When they talk about me, God is God.
Yeah.
Amen.
I don't care what's going on, God is God.
Yeah.
Through the good time, through the bad time, through the sad time, through the best of the situation, through the worst of the situation, God is still to be thankful. God is good, y'all.
All right.
Paul is writing to the Colossians, tell them in everything, give thanks unto God.
Yeah.
We may have trials, we may have ups and downs.
Yes, sir.
But give thanks unto God.
Yes,
as I closed today, it was a song a while back, and we were singing. It was a great praise and worship song.
Yes, sir.
And the song was "Praise Is What I Do."
Yeah.
It said, "Praise Is What I Do."
Yeah.
Even when I'm going through,
yeah,
I still learn to worship.
Yeah,
him.
Yeah.
Through my circumstances,
yeah.
Even through my chances, amen.
Right.
My praises, amen. Well, I will always glad, amen.
Right,
and say, I vow to praise you through the good
and the bad.
I praise you. Whether happy or sad, I praise you. I go through all that I go through, but praise is what
praise
I do.
Because
I owe it
all
to you.
Yeah.
A true thanksgiving will let us know that we owe it all to him. So this Thanksgiving will be like, you know what, Thanksgiving? The end of us ever
understand.
This Thanksgiving, we'll have time to focus on the Lord.
This
Thanksgiving,
praise.
We ain't got to worry about if the tide just right.
Is the
potato salad just
right?
Is Martha going to bring the bass? Forget it. Amen. We ain't got to worry about none of those things this year. All that we got to do is worry about
praise
and praise God. Amen.
Amen.
Come on, children, don't you
Amen. So tomorrow, I'm picking on you, but you know everybody.
Got something.
Amen.
You know, not you.
You know, he brought some ribs in his last year. They were tough. You got to worry about all that.
You got to worry about it. And you get home and enjoy the Lord and your wife.
Lord, I pray to God that I'm bringing that pumpkin pie and I got to eat. Amen. Those type of things we don't worry about.
Yes, sir.
Well, let's start putting our focus on Christ.
That's right.
And like I said, not just on Thanksgiving. And that's truly give thanks unto Him.
Amen.
We all got somebody in our family when they show up with that dish.
Amen.
Ain't that right? Everybody got somebody out there. She ain't got to cook, God.
Yeah.
And she put it off.